Hello, everybody. This week we have a very special anniversary, the death anniversary or yahrzeit of Rashi, a tremendously important Jewish scholar who changed the nature of Jewish education for hundreds of years. Let's have a very quick look at his life and his achievements. So, first of all, Rashi is without a doubt the most important commentator on the Torah. It is from Rashi that we get the expression of learning Torah with two fingers, which means you have one finger in the Torah itself and another finger in Rashi's commentary, primarily because Rashi presents the traditional rabbinic interpretive tradition in such a pithy, concise, and appealing manner. So he's the commentator par excellence. If you look at the copy of a traditional page of the Torah, for example, here you can see on the top left is the Torah itself. Just to the left of it is the Aramaic translation of Onkelos, which was extremely useful in the ancient period and of course is still studied today. But then underneath it you have Rashi's commentary, and I'll explain a little bit about why that is so important momentarily. But note also that beside Rashi you often have a super commentary. Since Rashi provides so much information, there are more than 200 such super commentaries on Rashi. This one happens to be the Sifsei Chachami, a very important one of the modern era. Rashi lived in the 11th century, primarily in medieval Ashkenaz. He was very active in the Rhineland, particularly in the tri-towns of Speyer, Worms, and Mainz, and also in the south, in the French regions, Provence, places like that, where he established a rabbinical school, and he was also a businessman of some note. You can see here I have highlighted in red the dominant Ashkenazic homeland. Ashkenaz is roughly equivalent to Germany in the medieval period, but of course Ashkenazic Jews would later move to the east, and they constitute the bulk of the Russian, Ukrainian, Polish, Hungarian Jewish populations. In his time, Rashi was one of the most important of the scholars known by the term Rishonim, which means the first ones. Now, this is a period of time that encapsulates approximately six centuries in which there was some really important work done on understanding what is Judaism and expanding our comprehension of this tremendous text we call the Torah. There were many Rishonim who worked on Hebrew grammar, many Rishonim who worked on calculating the exact number of mitzvot. There are some who, like Maimonides, created huge systems of Torah. But what Rashi was especially good at, what his genius was, is he was a synthesizer. And most importantly, he took the traditional oral tradition, the oral Torah, and he laid it on top of the written Torah so that the verses of the written Torah could really be read through the lens of the traditional rabbinic interpretation. That's why Rashi is such a phenomenal anthologizer, bringing together a diverse number of midrashim and Kabbalistic statements and so on, and bringing them down into very short sentences that can be comprehended by young children. Rashi is studied at primary school level all the way through the aged. Many Jews have the custom of studying the entire Torah every year with Rashi's commentary. He also wrote an incredibly important commentary on the entire Talmud, a massive amount of words, and his style is exceptionally helpful because what he does is he takes the reader line by line through the text, holding the hand of the reader and navigating the extremely complex and arcane style of the Talmudic text. Really, it's impossible to get even a fundamental understanding of the Talmud without Rashi's assistance right from the very beginning. His legacy is incredibly important. For the last millennium, Rashi has been studied as an essential part of the Jewish curriculum. As I mentioned earlier, over 200 separate commentaries have been written on Rashi's explanation of the Torah, and he remains one of the most important thinkers in all of Jewish history. Well, that's it for this week. Thank you very much for watching, and I look forward to speaking to you again soon.